all green lights, everything's a go. Money on the table, count it real slow. Pull up that rosé, twist up that Cali dro. When you hustle hard, no matter what is hitting for.
What it do, Ski Sun Duelist? It's your boy YFGM Blog TV coming straight out of Cincinnati, Ohio. Now I'm going to talk about the Memphis Grizzlies versus the Clippers game. That was a great, great, exciting game. It came down to the last couple seconds of the game, tenth of a second of the game. Chris Paul had the ball in his hand. He shot the running jumper, and he made the shot to win the game. They beat him 93-91. Now, to start off the game, Blake Griffin was very aggressive. He was 6-10 in the first quarter. I think he had 13 points. So he showed that he wanted to try to dominate the game early, and he was doing what he was doing. You know, both teams was going at it. You know, the guards for Memphis was going at Chris Paul and them boys. You know, Tony Allen was playing some great defense on Chris Paul throughout pretty much the whole game. You know, it was like I said, it was a back and forth game, very exciting game. And then, like I say, I'm going to move forward towards the fourth quarter. That's when things kind of got interesting. I believe at one point the Clippers, they came out. They was hot. They was rolling. They got up about 10 points. But then Memphis Grizzlies, they end up making a 9-2 run and, you know, getting the game back closer. They end up tying the game, getting a 91-91. But before I go there, Chris Paul, man, you know, for those who don't know, I always say Deron Williams is my favorite point guard. Yes, he didn't play good against the Chicago Bulls, but I always say he was my favorite point guard because, you know, he got the size, the upper body strength, he can post you and stuff like that. But I must admit, man, I didn't know Chris Paul, man, he's kind of strong too. You know, he's probably underrated with that in that department too. He's pretty strong, man. He got some strength on him too. But, yeah, man, this dude, he can just, if he wanted to, I believe Chris Paul, if he wanted to, he can average 20-something points a game every night if he really wanted to. But since he liked to get everybody set up, you know, he tried to get everybody going. That's why he don't, you know, score a lot of points. But when he needs to take over the game, oh, he will take over the game. That he improved it so much throughout his career, you know, especially last night. In the last 3 minutes or something, he scored the 8 straight points. He took over the game for them, you know, and Jamal Crawford was playing well. He didn't win the Sixth Man of the Year award, which I said he probably wasn't going to win. Blake Griffin was playing well, and Chris Paul played a hell of a game. And if those guys, those three guys right there perform well, whew, I'm telling you, it's going to be tough for any team to beat them. But, yeah, he took over about the last 3 minutes or something in the game, scored the last 8 straight points, and then when it came down to it, he ended up hitting the jumper to win the game for him. So I'm pretty sure Memphis, it's a sour taste in Memphis' mouth because they had them guys where they wanted to have them. And unfortunately, Chris Paul hit that tremendous shot. Tony Allen played great defense on him. Even Chris Paul said Tony Allen was playing some great defense on him. And Mike Conley. Mike Conley, you know, he had a career high playoff high, 28 points. So he was playing good, some good basketball too. But yeah, man, this is going to be an interesting series. I said this is probably going to go 7, but, you know, we just have to see, man. Hopefully Memphis, they can go back. They're pretty good at home. They can win their next 2 games and make it a very, very interesting series. But, yeah, man, great, great game. Conley, them boys, them guards was playing Chris Paul very, very tough, playing them very well. And we just have to see what happens. My only problem is, like I said before, Zach Randolph is going to have to really, really score more. He's going to have to really, really score more in order for this team to have a chance. And, of course, the bench is going to have to step up also and, you know, contribute and play well also. You can't just have, a total of 10 points off the bench. That's it. Like, you're not going to win, beat anybody like that. To where, you know, the Clippers, they have about, 28 points coming off the bench, like, That's a better doses. Now, both teams, they didn't shoot the three at all very well. Memphis was 7 from 11, 18%. Clippers was 2 for 15, 13%. They shot the ball. Memphis, 45%, 33-73 from the field. The Clippers, 47%, 37-78 from the field. Free throws, 77% for the Clippers, 67% for the Grizzlies. Grizzlies got out rebounded just by 2 rebounds, 38-40. Clippers had more, they had more points in the paint, 50-46. But yeah, man, overall, Chris Paul took over the game, did what he does, you know, he did what he does best, attack, took over the game, like I said, won the game for him. This is still going to be an interesting series for me. But Memphis Grizzlies, they showed that they can dominate, you know, as far as they can play good defense. But this is why I say sometimes I wish they still had Rudy Gay or OJ Mayo to provide some more scoring for this team. You know, when they got rid of Rudy Gay, they obviously just had in their head that they were going to go through Marc Gasol and Zach Randolph a lot. So now they have to really score more points, you know. But anyway, man, y'all tell me what you thought about the game. Hit me up on Twitter. Hit me up on Facebook. Check out my previous videos. Y'all know what to do. Deuce.
And remember, guys and girls, make sure you click the subscribe button, watch the previous videos, and like the videos.